Humans have attempted to harness the great Mississippi River for nearly three centuries, but just how successful have we been, and are we making things worse? Hey guys, Julia here for D News. As the world warms up and changes weather worldwide, many places like the US and the UK will see more severe storms and without a doubt more flooding. But climate change isn't the only way humans have made flooding worse. We've been doing that for years. Basically, the best example comes from John McPhee's 1987 New Yorker article, Atchafalaya, about the attempted control of the Mississippi River. Basically, it goes like this. The Mississippi always wants to find the shortest and easiest path to the Gulf of Mexico. And every 1,000 years or so, it switches paths or jumps. And these can be big jumps, like anywhere from Texas to Florida. In the past century or so, the river has been itching to switch from its current course to the Atchafalaya, which would essentially cut off the entire current delta and all of New Orleans from the river, which of course is not good for the loads of people who live there and the commerce that depends on the river. So the Army Corps of Engineers took on the task to tame the river. They built old river control structure to limit the take of the Atchafalaya to 30%. But rivers flood. That's just what they do naturally. Water evaporates from the ocean, lakes, and rivers, forms in the atmosphere, and comes down as precipitation. That's basic. And some years it doesn't just rain, it pours. And when that happens, a river will leave its banks and flood the surrounding areas. This is natural and normal, and sometimes happens every year, like the Nile River. But ironically, by building control structures like levees and dams, we've restricted the flow of the water, making it faster, stronger, and more prone to flooding. Rivers do this naturally too. As the river erodes its banks, sediment deposits on the bottom of the river and constricts it. Like putting your thumb over a hose nozzle, it only increased the force and pressure of the river. To make matters worse, more water reaches the rivers than ever before, thanks to increased construction over the past 50 years from things like developments and parking lots. All these flat structures drain straight to the river rather than dissipating into riparian zones. This can lead to the perfect storm or flood. This combination led to a disastrous and catastrophic flood in 1973 that nearly destroyed old river control. After heavy snowfalls the previous two winters and more rain in the spring led to the most water in half a century to flow through the river. Many cities along the river saw waters above flood level for more than 50 days. In total, the flood caused over $250 million worth of damage. A report published in the journal Science concluded that the flood was man-made and warned that more river constricting and levee building would only make problems worse. Since then, two more floods rivaled and even surpassed the 1973 flood. The Great Mississippi Flood of 1993 killed 50 people and caused $15 billion worth of damage. It flooded 30,000 square miles and some places were flooded for 6 months. A flood in 2011 put old river control to its greatest test yet. Thanks to heavy snow and rain the previous winter, that summer, the Mississippi Valley was flooded for months. The breach of levees in Missouri, Arkansas, Mississippi, and Tennessee forced thousands to flee, and farmland was destroyed thanks to chemicals released into the floodwaters. So we haven't exactly learned our lesson. What to do about it? Well, we certainly can't move elsewhere. More people live in the floodplains than ever, and relocation plans cost millions of dollars. We could build more levees, but the levees that do exist already haven't been properly maintained, and really, they might wind up making things worse. Jeffrey Mount, director of the Center of Watershed Sciences at the University of California, Davis, said that the dark secret that no one wants to share is that there are two kinds of levees, those that have failed and those that will fail. Some suggest using floodplains as fertile farmland, not cities, and building a strategic overflow system or flowage easement into a levee. That way, they could be open more often and water could flow onto farmland, and the government would compensate the farmer for any losses. Some suggest using wetlands as natural buffers. Other plans include modern technology to better understand flooding. And if we don't take advantage of natural ecosystems like wetlands and make use of current technology to track floods, seems we will be paying the cost for years to come. Rivers aren't the only thing rising thanks to human activity. The oceans are rising too. To find out which countries will be affected, check out this video from Tara.
At minimum, even with extremely rigorous cuts to global emissions and oceans that are far less sensitive to climate change than we'd expect, 1.9% of the population of coastal countries would still be affected by flooding.
Do you have any innovative ideas on how to control flooding? Let us know down in the comments below. Hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to D News so you don't miss a single episode.